Hi, this is Somi Adeagbo. There is something I want to show you this morning. On the 16th of this month, I did a video analysis of New Zealand dollar, Japanese yen. You can go to my blog www.forexsniper.blogspot.com and then read the analysis and see those are important things that I discussed there. Okay, let's go back. We'll start from the analysis today. So this was the chart that I used then, okay, and I made mention that we are in a phase, we are in a very long-term corrective phase, okay, and then the pattern we are expecting or the emerging pattern is a flat pattern, okay, and this pattern started 2007, okay. This is the first leg of the pattern, ABC. This is the second leg of the pattern, and we are expecting a five-wave drive. Okay, to complete the third leg of the pattern. Flat patterns are 3, 3, 5 patterns. The second leg, used to be very deep. Okay, it's always very deep. Okay, close to the starting point of the first leg. While the third leg is often slower than the second leg, and it's a five-wave impulse move. Okay, and that is why I put these projections there like this. Okay. So at the meantime, now in the meantime, we are expecting a five-wave impulse move to complete the first leg of this move here. Okay, and price has been moving in that direction. Okay, since the beginning of this year, it's been moving that way. Okay, so let's look at what we have presently now. Now this is my price chart. Okay, this is what I was talking. Now this is the first leg of the five wave we are seeing here. Okay, this is wave one, wave two, wave three, wave four. Okay, the first leg of this move, this one here. Okay, so we are looking at this 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that's what we are looking at now. So this is wave one, wave two, wave three, wave four of that move, and then we are expecting a five wave move down. Okay, to get to this level that we discussed, we talk about price coming to this level because this level is such a very important support level. All right, so we're expecting the fifth wave down there, but what are we having here? The fifth wave could be an ending diagonal or a five-wave impulse move. Okay, looking at this very well from the four-hour chart, we could see that we already are the first two wave of this impulse move. That is wave one, wave two of this expected motive wave. Okay. And what we are seeing right here is another five wave move and then a correction here. Okay, we're expecting a third wave which is expected to be an impulse wave. That is a five wave move. All right. And this is the first leg of the third leg, the expected third leg. This is its first leg. And now it looks as if price is in the second leg of the five wave impulse move downward. Okay, now what is the pattern that has emerged here or that is emerging? Okay, I will show you that quickly. The pattern that is emerging there, it's okay. All right, look at this. This is a combination pattern, a complex Elliott wave patterns. Okay, we have three types of corrections. We have the flat, we have the zigzag, and we have the triangles. All right. And a correction is usually consists of three legs, except the triangle that has five legs. Each of them is three legs. Okay. Now this correction here is a complex correction because a complex correction is a correction that contains it's three legs. It's made up of corrective waves. Okay, it could be a combination of a flat and a zigzag, or a flat zigzag and a triangle, or a triangle zigzag and a flat. It has to be, it has it, it it contains two or three of the corrective patterns all put together. All right, now the one we are seeing here, I label it WXY. Okay, the W is a zigzag pattern. Okay, A B C, that is the first leg of this correction, and then the second leg is a flat. Okay, this one goes deep but not so deep, but this one could not penetrate this one substantially or significantly. So it shows that it's A flat. And then what do we see here? A, B, C. Though this pattern is rare, we call it the running flat. This is a running flat A, B, C, whereby the second leg exceeds the starting point of the first leg and the third leg exceeds the starting point of the second leg. So this is where we are now. So this is a complex correction. Okay, it's about completed. And there is one thing that that is so peculiar to the combination patterns. The combination patterns are horizontal in nature. Okay, they're just like in chart pattern. That's what we call a flag pattern, whereby price is moving in this direction, and now we see consolidation this way, and then price now resumes, okay, in the previous direction. All right, so that's what we are looking at now. So this pattern here, it's a combination pattern, a zigzag, a flat, a regular flat, and this is a running flat. Okay, so we're expecting price to come back from here and to start moving down, okay, in a very fast move, okay, that will make this whole zone to look so small. So we're expecting a fast 5-wave move, which is going to signal the end of the second wave of the fifth wave, and then the resumption of the third wave of the fifth wave. So if this is going to happen, it's going to be a very wonderful risk reward ratio. Okay, a conservative trader could trade around here and then aim to take profit as price moves down. But how do I want to go about this? How do I want to go about this? Let me get to my chart. Looking at this from the 15-minute chart, I have this to label, because a flat pattern, okay, let me show it to you again. A flat pattern is expected to be a 3-3-5. So the fifth wave here is expected to be a 5-wave move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is what I'm expecting now, and so that is what I labeled here with 1, with 2, with 3, with 4, with 5. So I won't be surprised if price does not break below this trend line now, if it moves up before it breaks it. Okay, and it could be that this is the first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, fifth wave. So the most important thing to look for is the break, okay, below this trend line. So if price breaks below this trend line, okay, breaks below like this, I'm going to look for a selling opportunity. But if price bounces from here and goes up and then breaks below, then I'm going to be looking for a selling opportunity around here, and then the stop loss is going to be just like this, okay, and then look at a potential profit. It's going to be very large. All right, so I'm going to update the subscribers of Forex Sniper Signal Service on how this trade is going to go. All right, thank you very much. I wish you a very wonderful trading week or day.